Hi guys, in the last video, I show you how to install ESXi on Dell R620 on the dual memory card setup. In this video, I will show you how to create a vMFS storage on a USB device for ESXi 7.0. So by default, ESXi do not let you store the virtual machine on a USB device. But you can do that with by manually create a USB storage vMFS storage on a USB device, and it can be done using a ESXi CLI command. And I didn't do I didn't figure out how to do it myself, so I actually Googled it and I found a pretty good tutorial posted by the admin users name FGREHL at vertin.net. I will include the link in the description and give him proper credit for it. But I will also include the text file with all the COIs, so if you can if you can download it and follow along, it make it easier for some of you. And with that, let's get started. So in order to do a CLI on the ESXi, we will need to enable EditX service or secure shell service. So from the host, we're gonna go to actions, and we're gonna go to services, and we're gonna enable secure shell or EditX. All right, now that we have it enabled, so if you're on Windows, you wanna go to command prompt. If you're on Mac or Linux, you wanna go to open up terminal. Let me make it a little bit bigger so it's easier to see. All right, and first command, we're gonna run at the EditX and the username root at the IP address or the FQDN to establish a secure connection 149.4.1.4.8. All right. And it asks for a password. All right, so now we're in the ESXi shell command. All right, let's open up the text file. So actually, let me go to the storage and devices. So right now, if you go to devices, you do not you only see the local USB direct access, which is this is actually the SD card that we loaded up the ESXi, and this is the CD prompt on the Dell R620, and this is one of the SSD that I have in the A-Bay configurations. But we do not see the USB internal storage, would have the MX500. If you see in my last video, I use a Crusoe MX500 on the USB device and plug it in the internal USB on the Dell R620. It didn't show up here, so in order to do that, we need to disable the USB arbitrator service. So there are two CLI command that you can use. The first one, it just temporarily disable it. The second one gonna permanently disable it. Keep in mind that when you're disabling this service, you can no longer pass through the USB devices to VMs. All right, so when I use the first command, all right, I'm gonna go ahead and copy that and paste this into the ESXi shell. And here we go. USB arbitrator is stop it. So I'm gonna go ahead and refresh it. All right, so now you can see that one more disk appears in the storage. This is actually the MX500 USB device that I have it installed on the USB M2 to USB device. All right, and this is the name of the USB device. We're gonna use that name for the COI command. All right. So I'm gonna go back to the text file. We're gonna change the device ID to mpx.vmfs. VMHBA 32 C0 T0 L0. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and copy this command to create a GPT or guided partition table. And we're gonna go back to terminal, paste the command. Alright, GPT created. We're gonna go back here. We're gonna need to calculate the and sector for the SSD. You can do that using this command, all you just have to do is release the name of the disk. Oops, so I'm gonna go ahead and copy this one. I'm gonna paste it in here. Oops. Alright, and we're gonna go ahead and copy the CLI. I'm gonna paste this in the terminal. And it's gonna give it the end sector. I'm gonna go ahead and copy that end sector so that we can create a VMF at the partitions. So the end sector is go right there. And then we also need to copy the name of the USB device. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and copy the whole thing to create a VMFS partitions. Copy and paste. And alright, it created. Next step is to format the partitions with the VMFS version 5 or version 6. If you go with version 5, you the first CLI. If you want to format it with the version 6 and you the second CLI. I'm gonna go ahead and copy the name of the USB. Keep in mind that you do not replace the whole thing. Keep the column and then one at the end. So I'll show you what happened if you do not have the column and number one at the end. Go ahead and copy this CLI. Okay, I know some of you might run into the issue. So it's gonna run, but I can set up permission deny. And you're gonna add in the column and one. I'm gonna copy and paste it again. And there you go, it successfully created the new volume. Right here, if you want to name something else different, you can do that. Just go ahead and change this to whatever the name that you wanted. And let's go back to storage. Refresh. Alright, and when we click on the local USB, you have a VMFS storage now. Go back to data storage. Now it show USB data storage. From here you can create any virtual machine. And that's it for today's tutorial, guys. If you think it helpful, give me a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel. In the next video I will show you how to install TrueNAS and FreeNAS 1143 on the ESXi. And I'll see you guys in the next tutorial. Bye.